Hey guys, it's Eddie the Magic Monk. As you guys can see, I've changed up my students table quite a bit. I've added some new fields and I've added a lot of new records. So what I want you guys to do is delete the table that you currently have. So right click on your table and choose delete. And so close it first. One day I'll remember to do that. Right click, press delete. Delete it. Okay, so now the table is gone, and what I want you to do is choose import XML file. Okay, import XML. So click that, and then I want you to find the data. So you should have downloaded this file from the description. There's going to be two files. Make sure you download both. Okay, and choose the XML file, click open, click OK, and choose structure and data, and choose OK, and it should import the students table that I have created for you guys with the correct data types. So 50 field size for the first and last name, birth date, and so on. So yeah, this is the fake information that I've created, and now we're going to introduce you guys to the select query. So let's go to create again, and let's go to query design to create a query, and close this window that says show table, go to SQL view, and then what I want to do is simply select star, which means select all rows from students. And if you run this query, what you'll see is basically it just repeats the table again. Okay, because every single row and every single field is selected. So that's what this query does. So let's go back to SQL view again. And this time we just want to select some different columns. So you can see that there's student ID, last name, first name. So let's say I just want to select last name and first name. So I can just go select last name, comma, first name. And if you do that, run it. So design run, it just selects these two columns. So let's use the where clause. So where let's go back to the SQL, and let's say I only want to select students that are female. So I can say where the gender is equal to F, right? Capital F with single quotation marks. And if you run that, it only selects all the females in our database. So that's what the where clause is doing. It only selects certain rows. So this part here decides what columns you want to select, and this part here decides which rows you want to select. So I'm only selecting the rows where the gender is equal to female. So only these rows are selected, right? Sarah, Phoebe, April, and Phoebe, two Phoebes, right? So if you go back to query, run it again, and you'll see that only these people are selected. Now, instead of using equals, so go back to the query design again, and instead of using equals F, we can also have something like birth date smaller than or equal to, and let's just put in a date, let's put in 1st of February 2000. So 1st of February of 2000. Now, the dates in access have to be placed inside hashtags to signify that it's a date. So if you run this, right, actually you can't see the answer if we do that. So let's go back to the query and let's put in birth date here so you can see their birth date. So if you run it, then you can see that it's only selected people who were born before February 1st, 2000, right? All these people were born before February 1st, 2000. So if I did it the other way, if I went birthday is bigger than or equal to that, then if you run this, it'll only show people who were born after this day. So all of these people were born after that day. Okay, so I guess I'll stop here. Hopefully you guys learned something about the select statement today. Thanks for watching. See you next time.